Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter. I wanted to give you a couple of debugging strategies and show you how to use some of the debugging tools that are built into Apache Struts. So to take advantage of the debugging facilities that are available to your Struts applications, one of the first things you want to do is make sure you've turned the Struts dev mode on. Now, a lot of tutorials will show you how to do that inside of the struts.xml file, but I like to stick with a zero configuration type of environment as much as possible, which means setting that right in the web.xml file, setting your struts filter to say, hey, we are in dev mode, struts.dev mode, true. As I said, I like doing that in this web.xml file a lot better than doing it in the struts config. I don't like having a struts config at all, and I don't have one in this project. Now, this is going to allow the debug interceptor to be turned on, which is cool. We'll take a look at that in a minute. The other thing I like to have in terms of doing debugging is the Apache Struts browser config plugin. And in order to get that, you've got to go into your Maven POM file and add a dependency. And I'm adding the dependency for the Struts config browser plugin. After doing that, it's always a good idea to just update your Maven configuration. So I'll update the project, just make sure that that jar file is downloaded and available locally. And with that done, well, I'm going to do a couple of things. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make it possible to call up the configuration browser when I click on a link. So I'm going to go into my register.jsp file, and that's this one that represents this here. So right under where it says trigger an exception. I was looking for that. I'm going to have this here that says launch the browser configuration. So I'll do a couple of breaks there. And now with this particular link in here, going to the register action, which everything goes to register action, but turning the config browser on when I go to the register action, I'll be able to do some debugging and see some information about that particular action component. So why don't I run that program, click on the register, run as, run on server. I'll click display that in French so it looks nice, and then I'll click this launch the configuration browser option. And when you see launch the configuration browser option coming up, you see this gives us the opportunity to go in and debug some of our different action classes. I've got three, bad call, display, and register. So you can take a look at register. It gives you some of the different paths that we have for input success and for error. It gives you the location of it. You can go in, take a look at bad call, shows you some of the information as well. So that's kind of cool. That gives you some information about the various actions that you have in your class and where they route to. Now, I've only got one register action here, so this isn't all that exciting, but I'm sure if you pull up your own projects that have hundreds of action classes in them, it might look a little bit more interesting than mine. But I think that's cool, nevertheless. Take a look, config browser, show constants, all sorts of fantastic information in here as well. Now, the other thing that I configured was the ability to go in and take a look at our actions through the browser. And so I've got the debug browser plugin. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to call in my display actions, one of the actions that I have. But because I've set the dev environment to true, I can pull up this browser. So I'll click on the browser here, and you can see it's giving me all sorts of information about the display action right in my browser. So it gives me the locale, gives me information about the request, gives me information about the action. And that's how you can work with some of the built-in debugging features of Struts. And there you go, that's how easy it is to debug some of your Apache Struts applications, or at least give you some tools to start debugging it anyways. Now, if you enjoyed this tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great tutorials on Struts and Spring and Hibernate and anything to do with enterprise software development, especially in the Java realm. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.